Grace and peace be unto you from God our Father. Let's continue with our journey through Messiah, where we left off yesterday. Let's move into the way to rest. Come unto him, all ye that labor. Come unto him that are heavy laden, and he will give you rest. Take his yoke upon you, and learn from him. For he is meek and lowly of heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. These words come to us from Matthew 11, 28 and 29. You know, there's no point in placing our burdens on those who are unwilling or unable to carry them. The perfect burden bearer is willing and able, but can only bear what we are prepared to transfer to them. Messiah takes the liberty here of transposing the words of Jesus from the first person, come unto me, to the third person, come unto him. But the invitation remains the same. Jesus, during his earthly ministry, spent a great deal of his time bearing other people's burdens. He consoled the sad, healed the sick, touched the outcast, fed the crowds, saved a wedding feast from disaster when the wine ran out. He's been called the man for others. And that's a very fair description of his approach. No one who turned to him was sent away empty. No one who asked for his help was told he was too busy or had more important things to do. So when Jesus said to the people of his day, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, it was an invitation full of hope. They had seen what he could do, and he was now offering that same strength, support, and help to those who needed it most. It was not an invitation to those who found life easy, but to those who found it very hard. In that sense, it was selective. But in the time of Jesus, there are many people who lived, by present-day Western standards at least, in abject poverty and in hunger. His concern for the poor is evident all through the Gospels. But a further burden on the people of his time was the yoke of legalistic religion. The rabbis spoke of the yoke of the law, which God's people should be proud to carry. But for the poor and the oppressed especially, the law itself was sometimes the last straw that broke the camel's back. So in every way, this offer was to those who lived under crushing burdens of outward poverty or inward care. Come unto me. Do his words have anything to say to us, most of whom do not live in abject poverty or facing crushing demands on us day by day? The first thing to say is that they empathetically do speak with power and hope to those, today as in every day, and in every age, who are poor or trapped under their circumstances. Those circumstances can make life just a crushing burden. There are those who care for elderly loved ones or severely handicapped family members. But there are also those whose burdens are less physical, but no less exhausting. Those struggling with instincts and inner drives that they find hard to control. Those living in loveless or violent relationships from which there seems no escape. Those longing to be rid of sin that threatens to destroy them. And there are some, now as then, for whom religion itself, sadly, is a heavy load to bear. All these are grievous burdens that people carry, which make burdens feel so heavy laden. So how can Jesus relieve the strain? In what sense can he, who is no longer with us in the flesh, be a burden bearer? The answer is in that old word, yoke. A yoke linked to beasts of burden, which in normal circumstances would mean that the load was halved for each of them. I say in normal circumstances because sometimes the owner would partner a very young or experienced ox with an older, stronger one. Then the burden was not shared equally. The stronger animal bore more than half the burden, while the weaker one drew strength from its partner. That's the model of Christ's yoke. The burden is shared, but our partner bears more than half of it. The strong Son of God holds up the weak children of man. The ox had to bow its head to accept the wooden yoke that harnessed it, not only to the load, but to the other ox who would share it. For us, taking a yoke, it sometimes involves humility. In other words, a recognition that this load could not be bore alone. It's still true that some of us would rather bear our private burdens, however heavy laden we are, than humbly turn to Christ for help. Yet the invitation remains, however ostensibly we may have refused it in the past. Come to me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. In Matthew's gospel, this lovely invitation of Jesus follows two important sayings. The first is that the Father hides the deepest truth from the wise and learned and reveals them to little children. Matthew 11:25. The second is that all things have been committed to Jesus by the Father. 11:27. Then this invitation follows as though its sheer simplicity will attract those who have a burden, and the power and strength of the Father will be able and be available to help them bear it. the light burden. His yoke is easy and his burden is light. Matthew 11, verse 30. Sometimes a trivial thing becomes a huge burden. Sometimes a heavy responsibility can be lightly borne. It's not the size of the load that makes a difference, but how we see it. Back in the 70s, there was a pop song which talked about bearing a load on a long journey. A person who had to be carried. However, as the refrain explained, he ain't heavy, he's my brother. Think of that as you think of this imagery. Think of a young mother trying to carry a baby up a steep stairway with things in her arms and the child with her. I'm sure that she would never have thought of her child as tiresome or burdensome. In other words, even heavy loads can be acceptable and even joyfully carried. It all depends on what it is. I think that's what lies behind this deceptively simple saying of Jesus. My yoke is easy, my burden light. This doesn't mean that putting on the yoke of Jesus involves lesser demands on us than, say, the law of Moses, or that being his disciple is a bed of roses compared with ordinary life. After all, he makes it plain to his disciples that to follow him involved taking up the cross daily, denying yourself, and being prepared to lose your life for his sake. Yet it is light. The Greek word used in the gospel usually means kind, and it's probably refers back here to Jesus' words just before. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart. The yoke of Jesus is light or kind because he is meek and lowly. That is gentle and humble. He would not load us with cruel or unnecessary burdens because that would be against Jesus' nature. And of course, as we have seen, the burden is to be shared, not carried on our own. The yoke placed on the disciples is also placed on Jesus. We are not left to carry our burdens unladen. That's another reason why the yoke is light. In the old saying, a burden shared is a burden halved. Jesus does place responsibilities on us. Of course he does. But when he offers to share the burdens with us, if we come to him, he will do so. That, of course, is the crux of the matter. The burden we carry at his command was never meant to be a solo task. Yet often we're reluctant to come to him for help. Ask him to help with it, as though that would in some way be an admission of personal failure. Many of us know this feeling from daily work, having been given a task to do. We're reluctant to seek advice or help when it becomes difficult, because that might call our competency into question. So instead we either do badly or worry and agonize over it. When all the while the help is at hand, but we refuse to accept it. Come to me, Jesus says, with your burdens. It's a marvelous invitation, made even better by his assurance that if we do, his burden on us is light. His yoke is easy and kind. Paul told the Corinthians that God would not allow them to be tested beyond what they could bear, but would always provide a way out. Often, and for many of us, that way out will be the shared yoke of Jesus, who comes alongside to help us bear our burdens. His yoke is easy, and his burden is light. Is not a strong, 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 is not a strong
It's not.